Hello friends, this video on reproduction in organisms part 5 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So now let us see what is regeneration. If the parent is cut or broken into multiple pieces, each gives rise to a new individual. Now you might be getting confused with fragmentation, because in fragmentation also you saw that the parent was broken into multiple pieces and each fragment or each piece gave rise to a new individual. So here also the same thing. Is it the same thing? No, it is not. In fragmentation, the breakdown of the parent happened on its own. The organism, when it became mature, by itself it broke into pieces. But in case of regeneration, it is an accidental process. So that is very, very important. This is an accidental process. That means if accidentally the organism gets broken down into pieces, in that case each piece will be able to give rise to a new individual. So this happens only when it is being broken down. The organism on its own will not break itself. So that means we can say that it is not the same as the previous process, that is fragmentation. Now also we can say that it is not exactly the same as reproduction, as an organism won't wait to be cut to reproduce, correct? So it is just one sort of reproduction which happens under a situation when an organism is broken down into pieces by mistake. So this happens by some specialized cells which have the capacity to develop into different body parts, and this process is known as development. So as I said, it is accidental process and it is seen in Hydra, flatworm and tapeworm. If you see, all of these has other ways of reproduction. For example, Hydra can reproduce by budding. Similarly, planaria can undergo fragmentation, and tapeworm can also undergo budding. So that means they have other processes for reproduction, because they cannot rely on regeneration to reproduce. They cannot just wait that, okay, somebody will come and cut me into pieces, then I'll reproduce. That is not practical. But these organisms have the speciality that if by mistake they are broken down, they will be capable of giving rise to a new organism. Now look at this example of planaria. See, suppose if it is broken down like this, the head has the capacity to give rise to the other body parts. Similarly, the middle portion of the body can give rise to head and the tail portion, and similarly. So this capability of the specialized cells to give rise to the different body parts, that is known as development. This process is development. So this is the entire process of regeneration. So now we will talk about another important method of asexual reproduction, that is spore formation. It is a very common process by which many organisms reproduce. So how do they reproduce? New individuals are formed by germination of spores. So spores are produced. So what are spores? Let us have a look at that. So what are spores? These are unicellular bodies in the parent that are capable of growing into a new individual. So small structures which are produced by the parent body, and those small structures can give rise to a new individual. For example, I'll give you an analogy to this. Like you would have seen that you often plant a small tree in your house with the help of the seeds. So what are seeds? They are small structures, but they are capable of growing into a big plant. So similarly, these spores are small bodies which are capable of growing into a new individual. And these spores are released by the parent organism. So here in the picture, you can actually see the mold, and they have thread-like structures on top of which there are tiny blobs which are called sporangia. So if you see, it is like this, the thread-like structures, and on the top of thread-like structures you have bulb-like structures which are called sporangia. And these sporangia, so they are called sporangia, and the sporangia contain the spores. So inside the sporangia you have the spores. Now, repeated division of the nuclei forms multiple spores inside the sporangia. The spores are covered with thick walls so that they can get protection against unfavorable conditions. Now, whenever these sporangia come in contact with a moist surface, the spores are released. Now when the spores are released, so from wherever they are released, from there they begin to grow. It is generally seen in organisms like algae, bacteria and fungi. And the spores are very small, very tiny. That is why they get easily carried away by wind, water, or by even by animals. And that is how they grow. They develop into new organisms in different regions also, because they can get dispersed. Now, some of the common spores which are seen in different organisms. Let us have a look at that. Conidia. So, what are conidia? It is generally seen in the fungus. They are non-motile spores. That is, they cannot move from one place to another. They are non-motile. It is mostly seen in Penicillium, which is a fungus. What does it do? They are also called mitospores, and these spores are capable of giving rise to new organisms. So here you can see these spores, so they are non-motile. Zoospores are one of the most common of the spores, and they are motile spores. That is, they can move from one place to another. They are very microscopic, that is extremely small, and they use flagellum for their locomotion. So here you see, these are the zoospores. This is how the structure of zoospores will look like, and they have a flagella. So the zoospores are all present inside the structure, and then when they come in contact with favorable conditions, they get released. Then each of them then can give rise to a new organism altogether. So they used as a mode of asexual reproduction by some algae, bacteria and fungi. As I said, spores are commonly used by algae, bacteria and fungi. Now some spores are motile, some are non-motile. So that depends from organism to organism. But basically, they all are contained inside a structure with proper protective covering, so that they can be protected against unfavorable conditions. And whenever favorable conditions are there, they give rise to a new organism.
Thank you. Please visit www.examfeo.com to watch more videos, attempt free online test, get free study material, find tutors and mentors. Thank you once again.